Ara and Semiramis. From the History of Armenia, by Moses of Korin. For a few years before the death of Ninus, Ara reigned over Armenia under his protectorate, and found the same favor in his eyes as his father Aram had done. But that wanton and lustful woman Semiramis, having heard speak for many years of the beauty of Ara, wished to possess him, only she ventured not to do anything openly. But after the death or the escape to Crete of Ninus, as it hath been affirmed unto me, she discovered her passion freely, and sent messengers to Ara the Beautiful with gifts and offerings, with many prayers and promises of riches, begging him to come to her to Nineveh and either wed her and reign over all that Ninus had possessed, or fulfill her desires and return in peace to Armenia, with many gifts. And when the messengers had been and returned many times and Ara had not consented, Semiramis became very wroth, and she arose and took all the multitude of her hosts and hastened to the land of Armenia, against Ara. But, as she had beforehand declared, it was not so much to kill him and persecute him that she went, as to subdue him and bring him by force to fulfill the desires of her passion. For having been consumed with desire by what she had heard of him, on seeing him she became as one beside herself. She arrived in this turmoil at the plains of Ara, called after him Ararat. And when the battle was about to take place she commanded her generals to devise some means of saving the life of Ara. But in the fighting the army of Ara was beaten, and Ara died, being slain by the warriors of Semiramis. And after the battle the queen sent out to the battlefield to search for the body of her beloved amongst those who had died. And they found the body of Ara amongst the brave ones that had fallen, and she commanded them to place it in an upper chamber in her castle. But when the hosts of Armenia arose once more against Queen Semiramis to avenge the death of Ara, she said, "I have commanded the gods to lick his wounds, and he shall live again." At the same time she thought to bring Ara back to life by witchcraft and charms, for she was maddened by the intensity of her desires. But when the body began to decay, she commanded them to cast it into a deep pit, and to cover it. And having dressed up one of her men in secret, she sent forth the fame of him thus, "The gods have licked Ara and have brought him back to life again, thus fulfilling our prayers and our pleasure. Therefore from this time forth shall they be the more glorified and worshipped by us, for that they are the givers of joy and the fulfillers of desire." She also erected a new statue in honor of the gods and worshipped it with many sacrifices, showing unto all as if the gods had brought Ara back to life again. And having caused this report to be spread over all the land of Armenia and satisfied the people, she put an end to the fighting. And she took the son of Ara whom his beloved wife Nuvard had borne unto him and who was but 12 years old at the time of his father's death. And she called his name Ara in memory of her love for Ara the Beautiful, and appointed him ruler over the land of Armenia, trusting him in all things.
This reading was from the book, Armenian Legends and Poems, illustrated and compiled by Zabel Boyajian and dedicated to the undying spirit of Armenia. The text file was produced by Jeroen Hellingman and the online distributed proofreading team for Project Gutenberg from images generously made available by the Internet Archive, American Libraries. This reading was brought to you by Inside the New Russia Project. Visit www.insidethenewrussia.com for more info or follow us on Twitter @ethnicstories.